guy was in here who did those valuations, there was a whole lot of, before the milk price fell and after, he did the survey before and after, and a lot of them said regardless of the milk price falling, we would have still bought it, we're land banking, it's good value long term, so it wouldn't have mattered. And it turned out that about 10% are sort of the family farms that were getting hurt. Those are the groups, if you like, Federated Farmers speaks loudest for. But some of the big organisations that have long-term land use, they were quite happy with that. Some of the farms went up 46%, and in town it was about zero. So my question is, why did you harmonise the farm prices from 46% and had an average of 10%? I would have said, caveat emptor, which is buyer beware, if you're speculating in the farming thing and you buy a farm in South Waikato and it's a higher price and the rate's a 45% increase, then let that farmer, the person who bought that farm, have a 40%. What's 45% increase on 20,000? It's 30,000. But I did an analysis on here. If you own a $100,000 house in town, maybe Bill Meacham's house, and you're paying 2,000 in rates, that's a 1 to 50. Now that farmer, that guy, let's say he's got a $6 million farm and he's paying 20,000 in rates, that's 1 to 300. There's no equity. That's what Bernard Hobbs was saying. They've been pleading poor for the last 20 years, and there's a gradual difference between the urban, what they pay, so it's 1 to 50 in the urban, and it's 1 to 300 in the rural. I'm just trying to bring it back up and just have a bit of a look. Okay, that's my answer to that.
Councillor, just with the 18 to 14 million thousand sections, what would these 18 to 35-year-olds do?
Well, they don't all arrive at once. So I've been out doing some surveys with businesses. So I've asked guys at Holsters, I said, what sort of growth would you want in your business? You know, with a new builder's pole and a new bit of nails and stuff, that wouldn't break you. You know, you've still got the same staff and you've got someone annual leave. So asking the businesses how many people coming into the town could they handle? And that's really of the 6,000, you have to work out how many of those. You might only have 100 in the first year or 200, so it doesn't happen all at once. And there's some surveys that have to be done. And that's a good question for council staff. What's involved in 18,000 residents? Because you know Oxford, which is up by Litchfield, that was all surveyed out to be a big town, all the paper roads there, all the sections are there. So we've actually done it, and that's council's job of just doing the paper side of things. How the ballot would work, but I really appreciate you asking that incisive question on that. Because nationally, they're crying out for solutions. We have to look at that. And we get the brightest and best of the 6,000. I've talked to the YMCA, because they come through, if they come through the YMCA side of things, and I've talked to them and asked them, do they have some programs that we can filter some of the people that would come to South Waikato? You know, so there are organisations out there already that know how to bedding and all that sort of stuff. So getting them coming into the district, and it's good, because they need a 35-year-old, they have kids, school rolls go up, we don't have to close the second school, the numbers, the police numbers go up, the pharmacy, and you start bringing in funding from the national level, town gets a little bit rosy, back to that 20,000 we once had in Tokoroa.
Taking out the obvious question of what Councillor Gill said, of what are these people going to do, who's going to fund the land, the section? So where's that going to come from?
So,
and who's going to fund it? If we don't own the land to start with, who's going to pay for it? Who's going to fund it?
In the district plan, your current district plan, all farms can have three dwellings on them at the moment. And so council can say to all the farmers, there's 600 rateable farm lots, and then there's 9,400, there's 10,000 rateable properties in our district. So you just say to the farmers, we want you to get up to the maximum amount of residential places, because that's a place that mum, dad and the kids, the school bus drives past there anyway, and that fills up the school. So of that 600, let's say they will build two homes, as what you're currently allowed to do, so there's 1,200 brand new homes. Now that all filters through Holsters and stuff. So you already have it on your books, you already have the planning stuff now, you don't have to do anything different. All that's required at a governance level is just quietly moving towards.
Councillor Smith.
target.
So the farmers are going to have to pay 40% extra in rates.
They're
going to pay 40% extra in rates, but then you're going to ask them to build two more homes. So who's going to pay for those homes?
Okay. You're mixing those two things up. The UAGC thing is just to ask the question. Let's get back into the middle of the road so we can listen to some sensible arguments this side or sensible arguments
from this side. That's my point exactly. This is not sensible. It makes no sense whatsoever. We've had this discussion. It's ludicrous. And quite frankly, it's wasted our time.
We've also had the discussion on the contour of the slippery rocks, and you said that was stupid as well. But
absolutely.
We've got Ted going back to have a look at the contour to find out from an engineering perspective what gradient we need so it's not a trip hazard, because you brought up the trip hazard. Good point. So we are investigating that and we'll bring that back to you shortly.
Can I just point out that we as a community,
that's what I'm saying.
That's what we're to develop 18,000 sections that you say. People are going to want to live together in town in a cluster situation. So you're going to have to develop those in town. Rough cost to develop a section. We're talking infrastructure, sewerage, roading, lighting, all that sort of thing. Even if we don't have to pay for the land, $50,000? That'd be conservative, wouldn't it? Per section? That's $900 million. That would cripple this council, that would cripple this district.
Our town here.
It's ludicrous.
Our town here has a sewer system. Our town here has a sewage system for 24,000. Do you give me that? 24,000. It's set up for 20.
We're looking at spending 5 million just upgrading right now. So but it won't be 24 million.
No. But what I'm saying is we have 14,000 at the moment living here, but we have the capacity. This town's built for 24. It's a bigger discussion.
those figures are not right because the standards have changed for that. I thank you at the time for any more questions, we thank you for your passion and your ideas, and we continue to look forward to your stuff on YouTube. Thank you. Ms. Robinson, would you like to come through?